love you and worthily magnify your name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Reading from the letter first letter of Paul to the Thessalonians. How can we thank God enough for you in return for all the joy that we feel for our God because of you? Night and day we pray most earnestly that we may see you face to face and restore whatever is lacking in your faith. Now may our God and Father himself and our Lord Jesus Christ direct our way to you. And may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we abound in love for you. And may he so strengthen your hearts in holiness that you may be blameless before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ with all his saints. The word of the Lord.
Heaven and earth will pass away, but
on guard so that your hearts are not weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, and that that day catch you unexpectedly, like a trap. For it will come upon all who live on the face of the whole earth. Be alert in all kinds, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that will take place and to stand before the Son of Man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Gives us time
to get closer to Jesus. Advent is a time of waiting and expectation. I heard a homily yesterday in which it was pointed out that all of our life is actually an Advent as we wait to be united with God at the end of our days. During Advent, we wait for a lot of things. We wait for Christ's incarnation, his birth in the world as a human baby. We wait also for Christ to enter into our hearts. And we wait as well for Christ to come again. Advent is also a time of revelation and discovery. It's appropriate that our readings today and throughout Advent are just loaded with references to Christ's second coming. Today, for example, Jesus says, by way of Luke, that we had better be ready at any moment for his return. Paul warned the newly formed Christian community in Thessalonica to live in a Christ-like manner in case they were caught unaware when Jesus showed up. At that point, which was only about 20 years after Christ had been crucified, people believed that the second coming was going to happen right away, so he was very concerned that people be on guard. And then there's the piece that Bruce played for the prelude. It was Box, Box It Out, Sleepers Awake. And we sang this same tune during the entrance rite today. The words for it go right along with the reading. And since many of us were trying to read the words and the notes and everything all at the same time, I'm going to read you the first verse of it again right now. And so you can see how closely it meshes with these Revelation-type readings. If you want to follow on, it's on page 61 in your hymnals. Sleepers, awake. A voice astounds us. The shout of rampart guards surrounds us. Awake, Jerusalem, arise. Midnight's peace their cry has broken. Their urgent summons clearly spoken. The time has come, O maidens wise. Rise up and give us light. The bridegroom is in sight. Alleluia. Your lamps prepare and hasten there that you, the wedding feast, may share. To summarize that, we need to have our act together unless we want to risk being left out of the kingdom when Jesus comes again. An aspect of Advent that I find very helpful is the chance to take time to look at myself in terms of how I can change and be both a better person and a better Christian. When I am waiting for guests to arrive in my home, I usually clean, even if I'm pretty sure I will never get to that goal of mother clean, which means clean enough that mom would be happy with it if she showed up as my guest. You know what I'm talking about. If the guest is staying over, inevitably I go for the bedroom closet. Now, getting ready for the coming of Christ and preparing room for Christ in our hearts is a lot like cleaning the closet. You open up the door, you move a few things out, and then you see it. The mystery box. You don't remember putting it there. You have no idea what is in it, but there it sits. So you get up your courage, you decide you're going to open this thing, you're going to look in there and see what is there. And you do. Inside the box is a thing you thought you had gotten rid of years ago. Maybe it's a thing that you let into your home that you didn't really want, but took it to make somebody else feel happy. Or maybe it is something that brings back such bad memories that you almost feel like crying when you see it. So you get yourself back together, you close the box up, you take it out of the closet, you donate it, or get rid of it entirely. Some of these things are trash, not donations. As soon as possible. And now you've got room in your closet for other things. So Advent is absolutely the perfect time to check out the contents of our hearts and our souls and see what should stay and what should really go away so that there is more room there for Jesus. And when we have made space for Jesus, we can all ask ourselves this really important question. What are we waiting for this year in 2018 during Advent? Let us pray. Lord, this Advent, help us cleanse our souls and open our hearts more fully to Christ. Amen.
Please stand as we profess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father of all, Michael, Robert, And now let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
Things like that, the accessories for winter to give to our guests at the
ministry, and these out here are for folks attached to a man's house. And then we also have Boscov's Angel Tree, which is gifts similar to this, but that's a Boscov's for the guests of our food pantry. And we, I guess we put together more of the bags to hand out to people who are just like the homeless people on the street, the people who have, you know, no place to go. So we have those bags of snacks and some different things, things like socks and that. So if you want to make more donations or you're interested in getting involved, that goes on all winter, that is not just for Christmas. Am I forgetting anything? It's all in there, but I just really feel like, you know, the things that are really important need to have a mention. And if I mentioned everything, well, I guess that's because everything's really important. But I do want to say thank you to everybody because each person, it does a little bit, it adds up to a lot. And it is greatly appreciated. And I could see that on Friday, and I could hear that in people's voices when I spoke with them yesterday at St. Paul's. So, anything else for the good of the order here? Then let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor to the Lord. All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thy own merit. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right. And a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life. And when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all company in heaven, who forever sing his hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood in the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation, by him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Thank you.
Our post-communion prayer is found on page 366. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. May Almighty God, by whose providence our Savior Christ came among us in great humility, sanctify you with the light of his blessing, and set you free from all sin. Amen. May him whose second coming in power and great glory we await, may you steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and constant in love. Amen. May you who rejoice in the first advent of our Redeemer at his second advent be rewarded with unending life. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Thank you.